Welcome to this brief tutorial on Academic Search Complete. When you are starting academic research for almost any subject area, this is a great database to try first. You can think of it as the Super Kmart of databases. It has a little bit of everything you might need across disciplines. Doesn't mean it contains everything, but it does contain quite a bit. You'll notice that the database has an icon in the upper left-hand corner that says EBSCOhost. That is not the name of the database. Rather, that's the name of the company that owns the database. EBSCO owns many of the databases that we subscribe to at Elizabethtown College. But just because they have a similar layout, all EBSCO databases are not the same. EBSCO databases always give you three blank search boxes. You'll also note the pull-down menus to the right. You can leave this as is to do a general keyword search, or you can change it to narrow your search results. For now, let's leave it, and we'll enter the term Shakespeare. And we get a lot of results, 25,028. Keep in mind that the more search terms you enter, the fewer results you'll get. Also remember, in a database, you want to enter keywords, not phrases. So once you have a research question, add the most significant words from your question into the database. Let's say we are interested in Shakespeare's play Othello, and whether Iago is motivated by racism. We could enter keywords like Othello and Iago and racism. Let's see what we get. Only two results. So we didn't get enough results. But we could change our terms. Searching in databases can sometimes involve the use of different combinations of search terms to find what you're looking for. Just because you don't find what you're looking for on your first or second try doesn't mean there's a problem with your topic. So let's try some different terms. Let's try Othello and the term race. Now we have 70 results. That's much better. If we want to limit our results, you'll notice that to the left there are limiters. If we only want scholarly articles, we can select the scholarly article box, and it will limit it. You'll see it goes down to 52. There's also a limiter for full text articles. That would be articles that we have immediate access to the full text. Click on that, limit it again. Now we have 45 results. You also notice that a range of publication years, and you can click and drag the arrow buttons to change the year ranges. You can also explore other limiters in the left-hand column. Let's click on the article Racism in Othello. That's the fifth one down. Here you will find record information for this article. The abstract is important because it contains a summary of the article. You'll want to read this before you download or email the article to yourself to make sure it fits your topic. I selected this article because it seems like a good fit for my topic based on the title. And then when I read the abstract, it still seems like a good article for my topic. To the left, you'll see a link to the PDF for this article, and you could download or print the PDF. To the right are some additional tools. I'll note the email tool. Here you can email the article to yourself. Enter your email address in the blank spot. It has PDF selected here. If a PDF is available, you can send it to yourself as a PDF. You can also choose a particular citation format depending on the citation format you need to use for a particular class. Another notable item here in the tools column is the cite button. If you just want a citation that you can copy for this article, copy and paste it. A bunch of citations in different styles are listed here. This concludes our brief introduction to Academic Search Complete. If you have any questions, please contact me at cohenjp@etown.edu.